Here with defensive line coach Odo Higgins. Coach, just the ability for you guys to be able to work together for an entire year without all the problems with COVID and not to be able to be around the players the full spring and off season. What is that doing for you?
It's doing a lot for me, man. You get to know each other better and as a staff and seeing each other. But you think about last year, COVID hit, we didn't get to know each other. We didn't get to spend much time. Coach Novell, you know, had some outings with the coaching staff, and we got together, had a lot of fun together. And also with the kids, having to work with them without saying, oh, we got to do this, got to do this. But it's been great. It has been great, team.
Now, how's your unit doing? I mean, obviously you got a couple pretty big players, you know, left your roster from this year, but you got some guys coming up. You got Coop, you got Fabian. I mean, how is that unit looking going into camp?
They're working hard. Coach Storm is putting them through the ring. He's working them hard, you know, conditioning, lifting weights and things. I feel pretty good about the group I have.
You know, Marvin leaving, there's some leadership, you know, holes. Who is going to step into that role and be the leaders of your group this year?
You got Fabian, you got Briggs, you got Coop, you got guys like that, you know, and that's what we want to create. You want to create the leadership quality guys like Fabian and Coop.
Now, Coach, knowing you for a long time, you always want more and more depth, because I know your position, those guys take a beating in there, and you need to keep them fresh, keep them healthy. How's that depth going to be this year, and who are some of the young guys you might have to rely on to do that?
Well, the depth is very important inside, because you're getting 620 pounds every other play, pounding, trying to pound on you. But you got Malcolm Ray, you got True Thompson, and then you got Josh Farmer, true freshman, coming on. Then you got Jared Jackson, guys like that coming on. So we got those guys got to step up to help out.
How's it going to help you having a couple of defensive line, you know, or defensive end transfers coming in that are really, you know, Keir and Jermaine? How's it going to help your unit if those guys can play as good as we think they might?
It's going to help out a lot, man. Those guys, they're hardworking guys. And, you know, both of them got experience, you know. And Jermaine is a kid that can run, is powerful, and Keir. Both of them has a lot of football knowledge.
Now, who from your group, you talked to Josh Storms a lot, who from your group's kind of jumped out and really done a good job in the offseason in terms of strength and conditioning?
Well, all of them have, but Josh Farmer, freshman, coming in weighing 260-something pounds, he has jumped out. He's 280-something pounds. He got stronger, you know, and the thing about it is he gets stronger and bigger. He hasn't lost much speed, much conditioning. Josh Farmer has done a very good job as a freshman.
Now, Coach, I want to bring this up because you obviously have a long, special relationship with Coach Bowden and what, you know, what him and his family are going through right now. I mean, have you been able to talk to Coach at all lately? And how are you, you know, how are you handling and dealing with all this?
Well, I went over to his place about 2 weeks ago on a Tuesday, and I talked with him, and I said, "Hey, Coach, how you doing, buddy?" And he looked up and said, "Hey, how you doing?" And he was upbeat and things like that. I talked to him, said, "Coach, we love you." I said, "Remember what you always preach to us. Hey, you do right now, when it's your time, God punch your button, you got a place in heaven." And we talked about that and talked about some of the old times and old things we used to do. But he had a good time. He was upbeat, and we all love him, and he knows it.
Yeah.
You know, the impact he had on so many lives is unreal.
Yeah, that's what I want to talk to you about. I mean, he has. Everybody talked to him, said how much they've impacted him personally. For you, what's the biggest impact he had on your life?
Well, one thing about Coach Bowden is, you know, something I learned from him. Being his age, you know, Coach Bowden adapted to the guys he had, like myself, Dion, and Sammy. He didn't change, but he adapted. And he treated us as people. Now, he worked us hard, he disciplined us, but he treated us as people. And he didn't, when you was a football player, it wasn't all about football. He got your heart.
Yeah.
And trying to save your life. And when a person do something like that, that means you don't go all out and play for him. Because he showed that he really cared about you other than football.
Mm-hmm.
And that's one of the reasons why this university, a lot of us, we're so connected, because we had a coach who really loved us for who we are, mm-hmm. not for what we used to be.
Yeah, appreciate it, Coach.
Coach, on